everybody. Welcome in. It's a great song, huh? Little Caddyshack right there for you. How's everybody doing tonight? Happy Sunday night. Hope everybody's doing well. Hi. So welcome in. Thank you guys. And hopefully you were able to watch last night with Uncle Louie. And then Kevin came in as well. And I thought it was a great night. I thought it was just a really, really good conversation. And I can't thank Uncle Louie enough for the opportunity to go on his platform and for Kevin for coming in and providing his incredible insight and all the support that was in there. It was just a really, really good conversation. And I didn't even realize that it went on for like an hour and a half. It was that good. And they had some really, really kind things to say. Some really, really kind words. And we heard other stories in there as well. And we had Stacy pop in too. I mean, it was a good night. I wish I could download it. I've got some recordings of it so I could put it on the YouTube channel. So I'll continue to try and get those and see if I can piece them together so that I can get those posted. Because I thought it was probably the best live that I've had this entire go. It was that good. So hopefully you guys were able to catch it. And again, I will try and get that somehow onto the YouTube channel. I just had to figure out how to do it and how to piece it together. It was excellent, wasn't it? I thought it was great. And people are so kind. You know, people are really, really, really kind. Yes, and a lot of inspiration. And I don't know if Jean's in here, but Jean the Queen, I got to tell you, her story and how she came up with an exit plan. And you guys see Jean in the chats all the time, but she got her permanent protection order and he is getting 10 years for domestic violence. It's just, that's worth it right there. That is so worth it right there. So I have some video clips and I want to try and get those posted. Yeah, and we'll absolutely do it again. Yes, absolutely. I think we'll go back and forth and it'll be good because being in that environment, it was such a safe place to be able to have that raw conversation. And Uncle Louie, Kevin, everybody's just phenomenal. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Yep, we're going to continue talking. We're going to continue talking about it. And yeah, 10 years. Not nearly enough, but it's something. It is something. Hi, JoJo. It is something. So that's why we come on. Yes, Uncle Louie speaks from the heart, and he's not afraid to say what he feels. And that's how I think everybody should really be. And he's so genuine and authentic. It's pretty dang cool. Yeah, there's no shame. Absolutely no shame. Because you're in a safe place. You feel like you're in a safe place. Thank you, Sarah. Thank you so much. I'm happy you're here. I am so happy you're here. Yeah, he stands for what is right. He stands for what is right. And a lot of the conversation last night, you know, I shared my story as much as I could quickly. But it was a lot about people wanting to get help for themselves. And on the other end, it's okay to be selfish, to do what's right for you, to protect yourself. And it was pretty powerful. It was really powerful. So tonight I thought I'd talk about that narcissistic rage and how to handle it and the backlash that comes of it. Because it's real. It's scary, it's unpredictable, and being in a relationship with a narcissist, it's hard, but when you have to deal with the tantrums, yeah, it's really hard. Thank you for the roses. So, I've got lots of receipts of rage, yeah, A lot of people have seen those, and a few popped up today too. Some old flashbacks from the summer that popped up too, and it just shows the rage. It's all right there. It's all out there. And so, I've talked about the narcissist and their egos and their illusions of everything should revolve around them. That their opinion's always right, that they have to have all of that attention. Yeah, there's some things. And really with the rage, it's when that narcissist thrives that attention and that praise to boost their own self-confidence and they don't get it, that's when the rage comes through. And yeah, I've shown you guys examples of what my experience was. Yes, and they will partner with other narcissists to team up and try and humiliate you. Now, that's hard. That's hard to deal with. And trust me, it's every day. It's almost by the hour on this end. Their whole goal is to try and humiliate you. Well, when you stand up, you have the truth, you show the receipts, you can't let it affect you. You really can't let it affect you because try. They can certainly try, and it's not going to work. But what it's not going to do is silence me. That's not what it's going to do. I think that that's the intent of them teaming up with another narcissist or other people to try and take you down. They want to keep you quiet. Well, that's just not going to happen. And so when you experience this rage, right, it could be short, super short-lived. It can come out of nowhere, and it can be very intense, extremely intense. And it can occur in a couple of different ways. It can be shouting, screaming, yelling, name-calling, maybe even throwing stuff. I've shown examples of all of those, every single one of those things. The other way that it can come out is passive-aggressive, silent treatment, just that kind of behavior. So it could be one extreme or the other. So my experience when it was the rage was the yelling, the screaming, the throwing of things, the name calling. You guys have even seen the old snap videos. You've seen videos on live streams where it was anger and throwing stuff, throwing cans of twisted tea across the room. What you didn't see was grabbing knives and cutting himself and blood going all over. It's that type of rage is what I experienced. But just to be clear, it can come in the complete opposite way where it's the silent treatment, it's that passive aggressive behavior. And if they do that to try and get control back, to get control back. And people, they often ask, why would anybody put up with that? Why would somebody put up with that type of rage in a relationship? Do you think he saw the live last night? I have no clue. I have no clue. I know other people did because they've made videos about it. But why somebody puts up with it? Thank you. I mean, it's really the million-dollar question. It's really the million-dollar question, and it's really hard to answer that. And Jenny's got it right there. Love makes you blind. And it's very easy to fall in love with a narcissist because they don't show their true selves at first. They don't. They don't. And see, we get trolls in here now. I know exactly who it is. And we block and we keep talking. So I'm going to keep talking. But they display that illusion, and you don't see who they truly are until later on in the relationship when that mask starts to fall. They never want to reveal their true selves for quite some time because they want to hook you so that you can't really figure out who they are. But once you do, because you will, the rage is coming. I promise you. Yeah, and he had episodes well before I left, almost, and not too far into the relationship. Not too far into it. But I mean, they could be assholes. I mean, they can really, really be assholes because they just are. Yeah, they could even hide it from their own families. But people that ask that question, I think truly have never met a true narcissist like this. And they try to only let you see their good side. It's the truth. Even their faults are twisted. Their stories are twisted. Their past is twisted. You guys have seen examples of this on live streams, in videos. I didn't know his family. I really didn't. Just a surface level. I didn't know them very much. Yeah, I didn't. Kids a little bit, but not much. There's an account right there. It happens. They come in. They'll create new accounts. It's just part of it. Thank you. But that rage. So, why does it happen? And how does it come about? And how can you really like anticipate what's going to come? Is something, someone has dented their ego and hurt their self-esteem. Okay? That's when you know it's coming. Someone's tried to challenge them and they feel like they're losing their confidence. That's another way. Or it's anybody that questions them. That's when you know the rage is going to come. So they live in this self-created world where they are the best person, but they don't have any evidence to back it up. They don't have it. Anyway, they don't have any evidence to back up that they're this amazing human being. I agree. But when you challenge them and you challenge their fake personality, they don't have the actual words to reply like a sensible, logical adult. That's when the rage kicks in. That's when they start throwing shit across the room. That's when they start lashing out at other people because they start to attack to detract the attention away from them. That is exactly what they do. So if they're challenged, if they're questioned, if their self-esteem is hurt, it's rage. And it's intense. It is super intense. And it's like they see red and they cannot let it go. They cannot let it go. Their egos are so fragile that they assume that anybody that questions them and their amazing personality, or that they're the best looking person in the room, or that they're a legend, right? They get mad and they see red. Facts. 100% facts right there. And they cannot hold themselves back because they feel betrayed. They feel hurt. You don't have my back. How many times have we heard that? And most importantly, they're insulted because they think that whatever you're questioning, whether if it's the sky's blue or not, they feel like it's a fake accusation and that you're just a commoner. Now, how many times have we seen this on this app? How many times have we seen that? Insulting gifters, insulting tappers, insulting... We've seen a lot of it. We've seen a lot of it. But you think about it, and it's kind of compared to if you put like a wild animal in a corner and somebody comes up to them, what is their instinct? Is to attack. That's what this rage is like. That is exactly what this rage is like. And the truth is that anybody, you're not hunting down the narcissist. You're just calling out the bullshit, but they feel threatened. They feel insulted. Right, Kevin is absolutely. So that's what you see in those. And it just doesn't end there. They're also going to sulk. They're going to use passive aggressive behavior and even verbal aggression. And they do that because they don't want you to repeat challenging them. So it goes from intense rage to that passive aggressive behavior, and that's when they become the victim, right? They become the victim, and they do that because then they want you to feel bad about what you did. They want other people, again, triangulate, and this is manipulation too, to make them think that you're the victim. And then they distract everybody from what the real issue is. What they want you to do is to admire and worship them. It's what they want. So, tips, tricks on how to deal with this. And I didn't know this. I didn't know what to do. And I think I tried. But you can't engage with it. When they're having their rage, what they want you to do is be by their side. Oh God, it's so bad. What you have to do is walk away. When they're throwing their tantrums, walk away. Don't engage in the conversation. And I will tell you, I'm guilty of, I've done it. I did not know how to handle somebody like this. I honestly did not know. So there were times where I would be upset and I would be, you knock it off, get the camera out of my face, you do this, you do that. I was pissed. I was pissed. And so you respond. You respond as to how you're being treated. You respond. And it's so hard not to engage that way. And there were times where I just walked away like, nope, not dealing with it. That hurts them as well because they feel like you don't have their back. You don't have my back. It's because you don't want to engage in this behavior. You know, the best thing to do is to not even get involved because you know what the end result is going to be. Yeah, so it's a lose-lose. I'm going to tell you, it's a lose-lose. Lose situation. But the best advice that I've seen and that I can pay forward is do not engage. Do not engage. Walk away. Do not apologize. You've done absolutely nothing wrong. Nothing wrong. Don't even ask them what's wrong and don't tell them to calm down. Do nothing. Just walk away. Just walk away. And it might make their anger worse, but it's going to be short-lived because again, it's how they do it. But when you remove yourself, you gain that power back. And when you say gain that power, it's because when you allow them to do that, they get the power. And like I said, you've done nothing wrong. So why would you have to lose something because of their tantrum? You shouldn't have to. So don't allow them to do that to you. It's, you know, truly for them, it's all a game. It is 100% a game. At the end of the day, it's a game for them. They're trying to control you, trying to manipulate you. And really, in a relationship like this, there really is no such thing as true love. You might love them, but you love a fake person. Just gonna say it. You're in love with a fake person. Because the person that they built themselves to be, especially at the beginning, it's not real. It is not real. And it sucks. It sucks. I'm just gonna say that when you think about the good times, you think about the love that you had, and then now, they always say hindsight is 20/20, but it was never really true love because it was fake. It was 100% fake. And people can say that the relationship started out because I lied, I sucked him in. You can spin it however you want. Fact of the matter is that he's a narcissist. He has a rage. He's got a lot of problems, and he still came here. He still came here. So, for the twisting of the narrative that says that I'm the manipulator, that I'm the narcissist, check your facts. Check your facts. If you have some, love to see them. So, at the end, what does your future hold? When you get out of a relationship like this, is you're gonna be a lot better of a person. I'm just gonna say, you don't think it for a long time. You are going to be so much better of a person. Just trust me. Trust me. And leaving a narcissist, it's risky. It is so risky. They'll always try and pull you back in. Always. I saw a live stream, what was it? End of last week, where he still says that he's in love with me. They will always try and pull you back in. But when you cut it off, when you walk away, and I cannot emphasize how important it is to have an exit plan. Come up with that plan. Write it out, draw it out, do it however you need to do, but I want you to share it with somebody else too. Share it with somebody that you trust. Because that keeps you accountable, and that person is going to help you accomplish that. So figure out your exit plan, and yep, figure it out, share it with somebody you trust, and then do it. Do it. When you refuse to hear them out, when you refuse to allow them to have the power over you, you can almost like soundproof your life. And someday you just hope and pray that they will finally get the message to leave you alone. Let's go back up here. Hold on just a second. So let's see. Do you think he says that because he knows you talk about this? I don't know. I have no clue. Yep, Auntie Barb. She can vouch for all of it too. And regardless, this isn't just about one person. This is about helping people to see what you can't avoid, because there's plenty of them out there. And if I can educate people on what to look for, what the signs are. Oh, this is Lexi's mom. No, what he did to your daughter was repulsive, disgusting. What he's done to a lot of people. So, is my mom in here? I see my mom. Give me a thumbs up if I have your permission to play some audio from the video that I found today. Oh, wait, I didn't see it. Sorry, I missed it. Okay. Thank you. I want to make sure. So I want you guys to hear this. Hold on. Give me 2 seconds. Lexi's mom, I want you to hear this. I want everybody to hear this. This was this summer. This is who people support on this app. If you guys want to record, go for it. I want everybody to hear this. I want you to hear this because this is the man that people support on this app.
My former future mother-in-law, you piece of shit, and I don't care. Just so you know, I won't call you a cunt or a bitch, even though you are both. But I don't call women that. What I call you is a manipulative, judgmental.
That's what he said publicly about my mother. That is who that man is. Don't believe the bullshit that's on there. Don't believe the dancing in Walmart with chocolate milk. This is who this man is. And this is who he is hurting people every day. That is the true person. That is not who I fell in love with. That is a monster. So if you're in here, I hope you heard that. I'll play it again. This is the true person.
My former future mother-in-law, you piece of shit. And I don't care. Just so you know, I won't call you a cunt or a bitch, even though you are both. But I don't call women that. What I call you is a manipulative, judgmental.
And that was done publicly for the world to see. Yes, it needs to be heard all over this app. It needs to be heard all over this app. His own words, and people support that. Other women support that. Shame on you. I'm going to sign off. Everybody, have a good night.